There is a new debate in Washington over Osama bin Laden. Should photographs of the dead terrorist be released to the public? Tonight, local leaders are weighing in. The White House is still wrestling over whether to show images of bin Laden following the firefight that killed him and shortly before his sea burial. Government officials who have seen the photos describe them as gruesome.
And tonight, there are concerns over the potential consequences of making them public. 11 News reporter George Letta spoke to two high-ranking members of Maryland's congressional delegation tonight to get their thoughts on this. George, what do they say?
Well, Ron, the president is weighing the benefits of giving us visual proof bin Laden is dead with the potential cost of those photos becoming a symbol of revenge for bin Laden sympathizers. There was also concern tonight from parents how to explain these images to our kids if they see them.
It's another crucial question for the Obama administration. Should photos of a dead Osama bin Laden be released for the public to see? Tuesday night, we posed the question to Senator Barbara Mikulski and Congressman Dutch Ruppersberger, each on their respective chambers' intelligence committee. Both said they have not seen the photos. Both lean toward keeping the photos private, at least for now.
I'm going to get a more thorough briefing tomorrow, but right now, I think we need to be prudent. We need not to gloat. But really remember that justice has been done.
In my opinion, it's about whether or not we make him a martyr. We do not want him to be a martyr.
CIA Director Leon Panetta believes a photo will be released eventually, but that call, he said, is up to the president. Some worry even a censored photo of a bloodied bin Laden is too graphic for the public, especially for children. Towson child psychologist Dr. Mahmoud Jaromi says parents of teenagers and younger should try to shield their kids from the photos, even though many of them see graphic violence in movies or video games all the time.
Because the video games are a man-made event, even though excessive exposure of it makes in some children's mind that this is real life, and that needs to be corrected by adults on a constant daily basis.
Dr. Jaromi says, particularly for kids 12 and younger who may see the photos, it's important not to overload them with details about what happened. Live in the studio, George Lattice, WBAL-TV 11 News.